Hello, I'm Odin, and today I'm not going to build anything. I'm going to put a build video out in a couple of days, so don't worry, you're still going to get one this week. But today, I want to talk about a tool that makes things. It's the Photon 3D printer by Anycubic. I like 3D printers. I really do. I like the idea of printing out something real, of printing, you know, objects. But it's not something I really ever got into, because I like working with my hands. I like just making stuff myself. And I've worked with 3D printers before, not this one, but I've always kind of gotten mixed results, mostly disappointment. Because the truth is, after like 20 hours of trying to set it up, all I ever get is colorful spaghetti. And then at that point, all I can think is, I could be done now if I was just cutting foam. Plus, once it's printed, there's all that sanding and filling and finish work just to get it so it doesn't look like it's 3D printed. So when Anycubic asked if I would review their printer, I really wasn't sure about it at first. But then I saw that magic word, resin. It's a resin printer? Okay, sign me up. I get to open a box. All right. Inside was 3 liters of UV resin. The two in the bags, they're 500 milliliters of the eco-friendly variety. And there was an assortment of tools and scrapers, some gloves and a mask, spare screws and the doorknob, plus power cords, and the printer itself. And all I really had to do to set it up was attach the doorknob. I was told that it was nearly plug and play, and it really nearly is, but I still messed it up, because the instructions say to set the home position by placing a piece of paper between the build plate and the LCD screen. Then you slowly lower the plate until you have resistance. So my mistake? Not knowing what level of resistance that they were looking for. Because just feeling the plates on the paper, having any level of resistance more than zero, that's not correct. Doing that with my first print resulted in a 2D spot where the build should have been. Basically, I printed a shadow. What I started doing is going to the other extreme. I got it down to the level that it was so tight that when I tried to move the paper, the printer came with it. So I let it up one level, and now I actually have resistance when I'm pulling the paper. All this seems pretty scary and excessive, so let me know if I'm doing it wrong in the comments. My biggest mistake was not talking to Joe Telling, the 3D printing nerd, because he would have told me what to look out for to begin with, and I would have avoided a couple of pitfalls. Once you have your home position set, you replace the resin tray, add the resin, close the door, and plug in the USB drive. And then you just print out the test object. Now it takes a few hours because UV resin is slower to print than filament printers. My first print actually failed, but the second print was perfect. You have to remove the build plate each time because that's the easiest way to pop off the print. Rinse the print thoroughly in rubbing alcohol, and that's almost it. The print is still a little soft, so just set it in the sun for a little bit and the UV rays will set up what's left. I'll probably get a UV lamp to help set up the prints when I'm done, because honestly, there's not a whole lot of sunlight at night. So, what's going on inside the printer? The build plate descends to the bottom of the resin tray, and then it lifts up to let in fresh resin, and it resets to the right layer height. And then the LCD panel turns on and shows the silhouette of the current build layer. This allows UV light to hit the resin where I want it, and it blocks the rest in shadow so it doesn't react and harden. After a few seconds, the build plate lifts up again, allows more fresh resin in underneath it, and then resets to the new height for the new layer. So the part actually builds itself upside down on the build plate. And that's why the plate has to be so close to the LCD, so that very first layer can stick to the build plate when it lifts up. And the windows, they're UV-resistant plastic, which protects the resin in the tray from the rest of the light in the room. Now, I'm super happy with the Photon printer. What I really want is to print small parts that I can't make by hand easily, like game miniatures and some small props. So if you compare the resolution of a PLA miniature to a resin one, it's crazy how good it looks. Here's a custom Lego head that I printed, and I was really happy with it, but compare that to the resin print. And then I stained this miniature to show the details even better, because my favorite part, you can actually read the numbers on the 20-sided die that he's holding. It's a good idea to position the mini so the front doesn't have any supports on it, because there's nothing to clean up on the important side. Okay, what about making props? Well, I started printing the Eye of Agamotto because I was actually considering sculpting one at one point, but seriously, this is going to be a lot cooler. So in a few weeks, I'm going to put out a video of me putting this together, showing you how the inner eye actually opens up, because this particular model by Black Ram Industries is really pretty slick the way it works. There's a link for it in the description if you want to print one for yourself or look at any of this other stuff. And I think I'm going to print some more small stuff from time to time with the Photon, so you're going to see this guy again. A resin printer, it takes a little bit longer to print an object than a filament printer, but there's very little cleanup work to do afterwards. The results are what I want from a 3D printer. Prints that look like what they are and not like a tight stack of layers. Because this is how Odin prints. Does that work? I want to thank Laura, Eric Lutes, and all of my Patreon supporters. You guys really do make this show possible. If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe. And if you have an idea for something for me to print, you can leave a comment below. And if you make any of these projects, you can send me a picture.